हेलो स्टूडेंट, आज का टॉपिक है यूरिनरी ट्रैक इन्फेक्शन। तो आज हम यूटीआई के बारे में पढ़ेंगे और इसके साइन एंड सिम्टम्स, कॉजेस, ट्रीटमेंट एंड डायग्नोसिस के बारे में पढ़ेंगे। सबसे पहले हम पढ़ते हैं इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट यूटीआई मींस यूरिनरी ट्रैक इन्फेक्शन। तो यूरिनरी ट्रैक इन्फेक्शन इज सिम्प्टोमेटिक प्रेजेंस ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म विद इन द यूरिनरी ट्रैक लाइक एज किडनी, यूरेटर, ब्लडर एंड यूरेथ्रा एंड एसोसिएट विद इन्फ्लामेशन ऑफ यूरिनरी ट्रैक। इन नेक्स्ट स्लाइड वी लर्न अबाउट यूटीआई टर्मिनोलॉजी इन विच मैनी टर्मिनोलॉजी आर शो इन दिस स्लाइड। नंबर वन इज अनकॉम्प्लिकेटेड UTI without underlying renal या neurological disease। इसमें जो UTI होगा वो बिना renal और neurological disease के through होगा। Next is complicated, जिसमें जो UTI होगा वो structural, medical and neurological disease की वजह से होगा। Next है recurrent, जिसमें greater than 3 symptomatic UTIs होंगे within 12 month following clinical therapy। Next is री इन्फेक्शन, जिसमें रिकरेंट यूटीआई कॉज होगा बाय डिफरेंट पैथोजन एट एनी टाइम। नेक्स्ट इज रिलैप्स, जिसमें रिकरेंट यूटीआई जो कॉज होगा वो सेम स्पीसीज से होगा और जो उसका ओरिजिनल जो होगा यूटीआई वो 2 वीक्स की थेरेपी के बाद होगा। इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड वी लर्न अबाउट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ यूटीआई। यूटीआई इज क्लासिफाइड इन 2 पार्ट, नंबर 1 इज अपर एंड नंबर 2 इज लोअर। इन द अपर यूटीआई मैनी डिजीज आर इन्वॉल्व लाइक एक्यूट पाइलोनेफ्राइटिस, क्रोनिक पाइलोनेफ्राइटिस, इंटरस्टिशियल पाइलोनेफ्राइटिस, रीनल एब्सिस, प्रीरीनल एब्सिस एंड लोअर इन द लोअर साइटेसिस, प्रोस्टेटिस एंड यूरेथ्राइटिस आर प्रेजेंट। बोथ अपर एंड लोअर यूटीआई आर फर्दर डिवाइडेड इंटू कॉम्प्लिकेटेड एंड अनकॉम्प्लिकेटेड। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड शो अबाउट एपिडेमियोलॉजी ऑफ यूटीआई इन विच सीन इन ऑल एज ग्रुप, इन्फेंट अप टू 6 मंथ, मोर कॉमन इन बॉयज देन गर्ल्स, इन वुमेन्स एट ग्रेटर रिस्क देन मैन, प्रिवलेंस 40-50% इन वुमेन एंड 0.04% इन मैन। 10% वुमेन हैज रिकरेंट UTI in their life and 7 million new case of lower UTI per year, 1 million hospitalization per year and incidence of UTI increase in old age, 10% of men and 20% of women are infected. In the next slide we learn about etiology of UTI in which acute uncomplicated UTI, E. coli, which cause about 80% of UTI and 20% of UTI caused by gram negative and gram positive cocci. Complicated UTI, in which Pseudomonas, Aeruginos, Enterobacter and Serrata are involved, isolated in hospital acquired infection and catheter associated UTI, virus, fungi, protozoa are involved. In this slide, we learned about pathogenesis, in which 4 routes of bacterial entry of urinary tract. Number 1 is ascending infection, number 2 is blood-borne spread, number 3 is pathogenous spread, and 4th is direct extension from other organ. In the ascending infection, which are most common route, organisms ascend through urethra into bladder. In which slide we saw about flowchart, in which organisms to colonize in perineal and periurethral area to ascend to bladder and kidney to UTI. Next route is hematogenous spread, blood-borne spread to kidney and occur in bacteria anemia mostly as aureus. Next route is lymphatogenous spread, in which men through rectal and colonized lymphatic vessel to prostate and bladder, in women through preuterine lymphatic to urinary tract. And next route is direct extension from other organs, in which pelvic inflammation disease are involved and genitourinary tract fistula are involved. द ऑर्गेनिज्म इन विच यूकोलाई मैनी स्ट्रेन प्रेजेंट बट ओनली फ्यू कॉजेस इन्फेक्शन इन विरुलेंस फैक्टर एम्ब्राई रेसिस्टेंट टू सीरम बैक्टीरियोसाइड एक्टिविटी इंक्रीज अमाउंट ऑफ कैप्सुलर के एंटीजन एक्टिविटी एंड नेक्स्ट इज टॉक्सिक प्रोडक्शन एंड नेक्स्ट इज प्रोडक्शन ऑफ यूरेस एंजाइम. In which slide we learn about UTI risk factor, in which number one is aging, diabetes mellitus, urine retention, and impaired immune system are involved. Next is female, in which shorter urethra, sexual intercourse, intraceptive, and incomplete bladder empty with age. Third is male, prostatic hypertrophy, bacterial prostate, and age. In this slide, we learn about UTI clinical presentation in which clinical manifestation depend on site of infection and second is clinical manifestation depending on age of patient. In this slide, we learn about clinical manifestation depending on the site of infection. Number one, urethritis in which discomfort in voiding, dysuria, urgency and frequency of symptoms are present. Next is cystitis in which dysuria, urgency, frequent urination, pelvic discomfort, abdominal pain and pyorrhea are sign and symptom of cystitis. Next is hemorrhaging cystitis in which visible blood in urine and irritating voiding symptom are shown. Next disease is pyelonephritis in which invasive nature, super pubic in tenderness, fever and chill, white blood cells cast in urine, back pain, nausea, vomiting are sign and symptom of pyelonephritis. Complications include sepsis, septic shock and death. In this slide, we learn about clinical manifestation depending on age. So, number one is babies and infant in which failure to thrive, fever, apathy and diarrhea are involved. In children, dysuria, urgency, frequency, hematuria, acute abdominal pain and vomiting are involved. In adult, in lower UTI, frequency, urgency, dysuria and hematuria are shown and upper UTI, fever, rigor and low end pain and symptom of lower UTI are shown. In elderly patient, mostly asymptomatic and not diagnosis as the symptoms are common with this age. In this slide, we learn about diagnosis of UTI in which microscopic examination of urine, urine analysis, urine culture and imaging technique like CT scan and MRI are used. In the laboratory examination, uncontaminated midstream urine sample use. Method for urine collection, number one is stick on bag, number two is catheterization, number three is suprapubic aspiration, gold standard for urine collection. Diagnostic test for adult with recurrent UTI in which intravenous pyelography are used. Next is voiding cystourethrography, cystoscopy and manual pelvic and prostate examination are involved. In this slide, we learn about management of UTI in which symptomatic UTI, antibiotic therapy are used. Asymptomatic UTI, no treatment required except in special situation and no specific therapy, more water intake and maintain acidity of urine by fluid like cranberry juice. In this slide, we learn about principle of antimicrobial therapy in which level of antibiotic in urine but not in blood and blood level of antibiotic important in pyelonephritis. Penicillin and cephalosporin drug of choice for UTI with renal failure. This slide show about treatment duration in which single dose therapy, 3 days course, 7 days course and 10 to 14 days course are used. In the single dose therapy, many dose are used for treatment. Number one is trimethoprim, amoxicillin, ciprofloxacin 500 mg and or Flexin 400 mg used for treatment of UTI infection. In the 3-day therapy, efficacy same as 7-day therapy with less adverse effect. Drug use include quinoline, TMP, SMZ, bactolactam antibiotic, and extended release ciprofloxacin 500 mg for uncomplicated UTI and 1000 mg for complicated UTI. In the 7-day therapy, use less for uncomplicated UTI, useful in recurrent case, pregnancy and UTI with other leak. In the 14-day therapy for complicated UTI and high risk of mortality and morbidity. Surgical treatment. Number 1 is surgical removal of renal calculi, bladder calculi. Number 2 is retroplasty and number 3 re-implantation of rectus if VUR present.